Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Style from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1528% of production. We've got a doozy today. Here's the data. The data has two things mixed in. It has ScrapRsn, and we also have production. Now, those are two different things. If it's production, then the quantity is how many we made. If it's not production, then that's some scrap, and we're looking at these quantity here, quantities, and we're trying to figure out the amount of scrap compared to the actual good units. So scrap divided by production. We're going to try that with a regular pivot table today. So insert pivot table, okay, and we're going to put ScrapRsn down the left hand side, and quantity in the values area. So this is getting me the number of units that were scrapped for various reasons, but I want to see that as a percentage of production. So this is pretty wild that we can do this. We go into field settings, show values as a percentage of, and where the ScrapRsn is equal to production. What we'll call this is percent of production. Click OK. We're just going to remember that's 308. Click OK. And so that calculation is actually working. So you can even look at the production number down here. It was 44,000 or so. 44,000 divided by 44,000 is 100%. All right. So far, so good. Sort Z to A. More sort options. Sort descending based on percent of production. There we go. And we're good. Then we want to see, we're going to ask for the top six. Value filters, top 10, top six. What they really want is they want to see the top five. I want to do that right. I hit the wrong thing. Top 10, top six. All right. And so what we're getting is we're getting the top five reasons that there were scrap. But we're also getting this production, and we don't want the production in there. All right, but here's the problem. If I do anything to get rid of the production, for example, insert a slicer with ScrapRsn, click OK, and if I would choose everything except for production, you see the calculation doesn't work because it's saying, hey, we want to divide it by production, and production's not in there anymore, and so we're kind of in trouble. I don't have a good solution for this. My first pass solution was, okay, you want a chart of this, let's just come outside the pivot table and we will build a little auxiliary table here that gets us the data for the chart and create your chart from that data. All right, but that just seems like it doesn't seem like a good way to go. All right, so for today, for this episode, this is my solution. Build the pivot table, come outside of the pivot table, and as long as there's not a tie for number five, this will be an accurate representation of what we want. Tomorrow, though, we're gonna take a look at this exact same problem, see if we can run that data through Power Pivot and use the power of DAX formulas to solve our problem. Okay, well, hey, I wanna thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.